Hey everybody, this is Ori from AstroWeb, and I'm going to introduce the Magento 2 commerce exclusive feature of rewards points, okay? So this is only for enterprise or for commerce. It's a really nice way to have the business give some rewards, give some a little bit extra to customers to maintain just a good relationship with them, bring them back to the site, give them some extra by being just kind of like a good customer. So if a customer purchases, they earn points. They can use those points and redeem those later on, get discounts, right? In addition to orders, which are the main reason why, or the main theme for someone, a customer earning points, we can also enable in the back end a few other things. For example, registration or writing review, and we'll show those a little bit later in this video. Okay, but points are the big ones. So I want to go over, first of all, show you how the customer experiences these things, and then I'm going to go after to the back end and show you how the business interacts, sets up, and interacts with customers and points. Okay, so I have a sample site right here, and I created a user. I've made an order or two, I've registered, I've kind of interacted a little bit, and I want to show you two things. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to go to my account as a customer, and I'm going to go to just say my orders, for example. So you see I've made a few orders. I just played with it. I've played with it before and after settings of the rewards points. If it's enabled for customers, you'll have a section here called rewards points. And under rewards points, you'll be able to see how many points you have as a customer and the actual exchange rates. So what that means are two things. Number one is for orders, how many dollars of spending equals how many points do you earn? And then for redeeming, for using when you check out, how many points will equal how many actual dollars, right? So you have two important things you have to do. How to earn, what's the calculation, and how to spend, what's the calculation, right? And you'll be able to set those up later, which we'll explain. In addition, you have a balance history. So I can see, if enabled in the back end, which you'll see later, how did I earn these 1,020 points? I earned them, for example, by the business gave me. Maybe I contacted customer service and they gave me something. And I've also made an actual order itself and I kind of received that, you know, these points. So based on an order that was invoiced and shipped, etc. Okay, I can also subscribe to updates. Maybe as a customer, I can get emails every time I do something and my balance updates, for example, from 1,020 to, you know, 2,000 points, I can get notifications as well. Okay, so I can unsubscribe to those as well. So as a customer, you can first see this, and then most importantly, you can redeem them. So I'm logged in right now. I'm going to go to a category. I'm going to add a product to cart. Excuse me, I already have a product to cart. So I'm going to go here to my cart page. And now I can actually go to proceed to check out and use them, right, if I want to. So here you see there's a kind of a alert or showcasing that I can actually use these, you know, check out now and earn this amount, right? So it's kind of a way to encourage people to check out and earn something. So a little kind of small nudge or small push, okay? This is how much I have, and if I do check out, I'll have this much, okay? So what I can do here is I can go here to proceed to checkout, okay? And I can go to the checkout page and I can try to use these points, right? So I can go here to the checkout page and I see, okay, I have 1,020 points. Do I want to use the points? I can click on use and all of the points will go towards my discount. So you cannot use partial points. Whatever you have, if you use it, they're used in entire, right? So it has to use the entire thing, okay? In this case, I had so many points that my order total is just $1, which is, you know, very good for me, right? Then I can place an order and then I use those points, okay? So that's as a customer, really, really basic. I can earn them mostly by orders and some other things, which we'll show, and I can use them. Really, really simple. There's a conversion rate. I have to use everything. Very, very basic. Very nice for customers. Okay, so let's look at a few things from a back-end perspective. So first thing you want to do, I'm going to jump back and forth here because I think it's kind of important not to go too detailed on the configuration. But first thing you need to make sure, go to store configuration, go to customers, and you need to turn it on, right? Before you configure and do all that stuff, you have to go a customer configuration. Sorry, excuse me. You have to go to customers and you have to go to rewards points. And you have to make sure this is turned on, okay? So the first two settings are, let's turn it on, yes. And let's also make sure it's available in the storefront. So that means customers can use it and see it, right? If it's not available in storefront, that means only the backend administrators and the customer service of the business can use these things to reward customers and to actually redeem for them, for example, in a back, what we call a backend order. What is a backend order, for example? Sales orders, create a new order, and then I can use those points, okay? But in most cases, you want to enable that, which in our case, we said yes on storefront, okay? So that's the first thing. I'm gonna get back to the settings in a second. The second thing you wanna do, you actually want to go to stores and you want to set up the exchange rates. So the minimum you're going to need are two exchange rates. Number one is, how does a customer earn? And number two, what is the exchange rate of customer earning? The second one is, what is the exchange rate of customer using, right? Redeeming. So you need those minimum two in order to have it run and work, okay? Now, a nice thing you can do, for example, if I want to add a new one, is you can configure many different things. So each website, for example, if you have multiple websites on one instance, on one Magento, and you can set up certain customer groups. So maybe you have a customer group called a wholesale that they earn double the points that, you know, a regular B2C regular customer earns, or you have a VIP group, they earn five times more points, etc. So you can do that. Now, this direction means one is for redeeming and one is for earning, right? So points to currency and currency to points. So currency to points means, how much do I earn? If I spend this amount of currency, I will earn this amount of points. And for using them, I will use this amount of points to redeem this amount of currency, okay? So you'll kind of understand that. So for example, I might say, okay, if I spend every 100 points gives me, let's say, $5 off, okay? And I would save it, okay? So that's the idea. So here, I set up one which is, 10 points equals $1 of spending, and every dollar you spend, you earn 20 points, which this is not really logical, but I just set up some random thing, okay? So, so that's the second thing. So let's look at the third and last thing, there's two more things remaining. I'm gonna go to the settings at the end. So before that, let's look a little bit about customers, right? So from an administrator, you can also see the amount of points for a customer. So I'm gonna edit myself, the front end user that I just showed here, that I created, this customer, and I'm gonna go here to reward points, and I'm gonna be able to see how much do they have, right? And have they subscribed to emails? And I can also, from here, I can actually add points to their account. So for example, maybe I'm customer service, this customer called me and said, oh, I have this problem, you ship too late. And then maybe my manager decided, oh, let's give them some extra points to make them happy. So I can give them, for example, here you go, 50 points. I'm gonna save it. Now the customer has 50 more points. Okay, great. So you can see some things about thresholds. These are settings which we'll talk about, and the points cap, etc. So that's kind of the idea. If I make an order, I can also use those points for them. So let's go here. Let's try to make an order. Okay, so I'm gonna go select the customer, select the store, and I'm going to select this customer. I'm gonna select my store view, and I can go here and let me add stuff to the cart first. Okay, so let's add this to the cart. I'm gonna add some products to the cart, for example, and I'm gonna go here. I have an address, I have billing and shipping address, that's good. And here you go, under the payment method, for example, don't worry about the payment method right here, it's just for a test site. I can redeem those points, I can use them. I can checkbox here, and you'll see that the totals are changed, okay? In this case, the customer used their points, and now they have a free order. It's a free of charge order, okay? So I can make the order, etc. So let's look at the last thing right now. store configuration. Okay, let's look at some of the settings that we can turn on or turn off for this. So we're going to go to customers, rewards points, and let's start. Pretty simple. Not too many features or not too many settings, excuse me. So turn on or off, we talked about. Turn it on or off for the storefront, for the front end customer. Yes. Allow customers to see their history of rewards points. How did they earn these? So if you remember before, we showed when the customer went to my account, they can see the history. It's really nice. I don't know why you'd want to turn it off, but it's really nice to do so, to keep it on, excuse me. So rewards points, you can turn off on and off the history. Okay. So, and these are some settings here. So rewards, points, balance, redemption, threshold. So is there a maximum that they can redeem every order, every time they want to check out? Is there a maximum of points they can earn? Okay. When they earn points, is there an expiration on those points? So for example, they would earn 100 points for every dollar or whatever. Every $100, they would earn a point. Doesn't matter. Will these points expire ever? If you keep it on empty, they will never expire. If you say, for example, 30 days, they will expire. Now, the expiration has two different types of settings. So for example, so static basically means when I receive, let me try to remember this. So static defines the expiration date as precisely. Okay, so static means that the expiration, for example, 30 days will expire the last time you earn some points. So if I keep on buying and keep on earning points, it'll always, all of my total points will always expire after 30 days. The other one is dynamic, which means whatever points you earn, those set of points will have 30 days in this case. But if tomorrow I make another order, or let's say next week I make another order and I earn 50 points, those 50 points will be 30 days from the day I earned them. So dynamic versus static. Hope that makes sense. Okay. Will I, if you create a refund, will I want to refund points back automatically? Yes or no. And this one, deduct rewards points from refund. So when I create a refund, will it automatically try to deduct it? Yes or no. Okay. Landing page. This is a selection of a CMS page for my earning of or my points. Okay. Let's look at the next one. So actions for acquiring reward points by, okay. So first of all, if a customer makes an order, do they earn points? Yes or no? Excuse me. My wrong one. This one is, if you remember when we were in the shopping cart, there's a message displaying right here. There's a message displaying, if you buy this, you can earn this amount of points. Before there was a message there. That row saying, if you buy this, you'll get 1,800 points, and now you have 1,020 points, it displayed only because this was set to yes, okay? If it's set to no, that row that you saw before that right now I can't see was displaying, okay? Now, here's some of the other features. In addition to earning on purchases, on orders, you can earn on registration. So for example, I set, if you register a new customer, you'll earn 5 points. If you sign up to a newsletter, you'll sign up to new points. You'll get 5 new points. Obviously, if you sign up to a newsletter as a guest, you won't earn points. You have to be a customer, right? That's pretty clear, or it should be clear. Okay, invitations. Have you invited other friends, other emails to join, and they've actually converted into customers? You've sent them emails. So that's another topic of another video, okay? Is there a limit for the number of people I can invite and earn points on, right? Converting invitation to orders. Have I invited people by email and they've come and they've ordered? So this is kind of to try to get more community, more people, more sales, kind of giving incentives for people to share with their friends, okay? These are all the limits themselves, okay? So invitation conversion to order reward, right? So do I only give them rewards if they invite for the first one, the first order, or every time that customer orders, right? So you can kind of see some of those settings. Like, do I give them rewards only the first time they give someone, bring someone to order, or every time? Do I always give them rewards as long as that friend always kept on reordering, okay? If they review, an administrator approve the review, a product review, I mean, how many points do I earn? So every product review, maybe I earn 50 points, okay? And is there a limit? Okay, so last thing, email notifications. If the customer subscribed, and in here we say by default, yes. Who do I send an email from? What is the transactional email? Which obviously you know you can make your own transactional emails by clicking on marketing, email templates, loading this default template. Excuse me. Loading the default template, and then you can customize that, which is another topic for another video. Warning, if you do have an expiry, like for example, we said 30 days they expire. How many days before the 30 days? For example, 2 days before the 30 days, I want you to email them to tell them, hey, it's going to expire soon. You better order, something like that. So that's kind of the idea. Hope I didn't go too fast on this. Let me know if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer. Create some more demos. Just let me know what you want. Be really happy to answer and go over anything. So thank you for listening to this video. If you comment, if you email me, I'll be happy to make other topics. Anything you want, please let us know. We'll try to make them. If not, we'll try to just, you know, we'll try to make as best as we can. And thank you again for listening. I really appreciate it.